Hello everyone, in this video we are going to cover all type of intersection lookups. So here we have index and match, Vlookup and match, Xlookup, indirect, conditional formatting. So we are going to cover all 5 type of intersection lookup. So let's begin. So first lookup is index and match. You are well aware of this. So in this we generally use match function first. So what match does, match basically find out the position of any word or any character. So let's say here we have April and lookup value is April. Now lookup array is this one, lock. So match type, what I'm going to do, I'm going to find exact match. So I'm typing 0, close the parentheses and enter. You can see here we have 4 position in April. You can 1, 2, 3, 4. So April is on the 4th position. And similarly, if we are going to find out the position of products, so now I'm going to use the second match, match. So here is the lookup value. Lookup value is here. Now comma, lookup array is products. Now lock. Now match type, again I'm going to use exact match, 0. Close the parentheses and enter. Now you can see product 2 is on the second column and apple is on the fourth position. Now if I'm going to change anything, let's say I'm changing this April to August, so what is going on, it is changing my August position, that is 8. So now I'm going to use index. Now my array would be lookup value, so here this all table would be lookup value. Now comma, now it is saying, even it is asking row number. Row number means what is what you are looking in vertical form. So I'm looking vertical form means I'm looking months. So I need to choose this 8. So comma, in column number I need to choose this 2, because this is in horizontal form. So 2 and enter. You can see the answer is 357. So product 2 and month is August, answer is 357. And if I'm going to change anything, let's say product 2, I'm changing it to product 5. So now it is here. Now if I have used 3 cells, 1, 2, and 3, you can build up whole intersection in one cell. Let's say I'm copying this in edit mode. So I am pasting it here in edit mode once again. Now I can replace this I6 and J6. So I6 have some formula. So what I can do, I can simply copy my I6 formula. And I am removing this I6, paste it here. And now I am going to remove this J6 with the same formula which I have used. Now copy. And now I need to remove this J6, paste. Now you can see I have built up all 3 functions in one cell, and the final function would be this one. So here is the index and match. You can use this one. Now in the intersection series we have second lookup, that is Vlookup and match. So we can try this by using Vlookup also. So what we need to do, we need to use Vlookup for this. So how we can do that, again I am going to use match function first, match. So match, we know Vlookup works from left to right. So what I am going to do, I am going to find out the position of products. So lookup value is here, comma, lookup array is here. Now lock, comma, match type is 0. So here is product 2 is on the second position. Now if I'm going to try Vlookup, so lookup value would be this one, comma, table array, I'm selecting this whole table, lock. Now column index number, here's the trick. You know product 2 is on the third column, 1, 2 and 3. So what we need to do, we need to add 1 in it to make it 3 plus 1 comma 0. So if I am going to change this, it will automatically change this 2 to any number. So now close the parentheses and enter. You can see answer is 245. Let me check the answer, product tube and month April. Here is the answer. If I'm going to change this July, and you can see 493 is here, product tube July 493, correct. So now if you want to make if you want to use one cell once again, so what you can do, you can simply copy the function in edit mode like this, paste it here. Now instead of this I6, we can replace this. So I'm going to copy the I6 formula. If you are not comfortable with multiple formulas one cell, then you can try this trick. I am comfortable with it, but I'm using this trick to explaining you, so that's why I'm using it. Now to entering, now here is the 493, and you can change anything, either product or either month. So answer is correct. Now let's find out the intersection by using our third method, that is Xlookup. So now what we are going to do, we are going to use Xlookup. So here is the lookup value. Lookup value is here. Now comma, lookup array is here. Now here is the trick. In return array, we need to use second Xlookup. So Xlookup. Now this time I'm going to use the same trick with the second lookup value. Lookup value is here, comma, and lookup array is here. Now return array would be your whole data which you need to find out. Now close the parentheses and enter, and you can see answer is 245 and it is here. Now again, if I'm going to change anything, let's say I'm changing this April to December, so it is changing. Now fourth lookup in the series is indirect lookup. Now this is a tricky part. What we need to do, we need to convert all columns, all row into a name form. So what we need to do, we need to just select our data. So I am pressing Control Shift F3, and you can see I am creating a name. So it will create a name according to columns, according to rows. So I'm selecting top row and left column. Now this trick only work only there where you have only one word. If you have suppose you have space, you have a special character, then this trick will not work. Even this intersection will not work over there. So what we need to do, we need to simply press OK and see what changes had happened. So it has created lots of name here. Here is the months, here is the products, here is the months. So what we need to do, we need to use indirect. Now here is the our lookup, first lookup value. Now select your first lookup value. Now you need to put space. Space is a symbol of intersection, so I'm going to use second indirect, and here is the second one. Now close the parentheses and enter, and you can see this trick is also working because we have only one word. Because you can use number in the middle and the end, but you can't use number at the beginning, so this trick will not work over there. So now here we are going to use our last trick, that is conditional formatting. So we need to select our data like this. Now go to conditional formatting, new rule. Now use the formula. Here we need to type end function because we need to check both the lookup values, both the values to find out the lookup value. So now I'm going to try end. Now anything you are building up in conditional formatting, the answer should come in true and falses. So I'm checking this one. Is this apple equal to your first cell? So I need to fix this. I need to unfreeze this row because I need to check this one according to row wise. Now that's why I'm not using a dollar sign in front of rows. Now comma, I'm checking the second lookup value. Here it is. Now equal sign and this one. Again, I'm not using this dollar sign in front of column because this time I need to check this column wise. So now close the parentheses. Now I need to fit the format. Let's say I am giving fill black, font is white. Now okay, so if anything would be intersecting, then the result would be this. Click okay, and you can see the answer is intersecting here, so that's why it is highlighting. Now if I'm going to change this April to December, so it will automatically intersect this, so it will highlight this. So this is the five intersection which we are using here. So see you in next video. Till then, keep enjoying and keep learning.